night service to Ambleside, Windermere and Bowness. We will shortly be leaving behind the village of Grasmere. This large but picturesque village is home to St Oswald's Church, where William Wordsworth and his family are buried. By the churchyard gate sits Gate Cottage, home since the 1850s to Sarah Nelson's Grasmere gingerbread, still produced in the original recipe today. We would like to remind passengers upstairs to please remain seated and keep your arms inside the bus whilst the vehicle is moving. Thank you. club based from the early 19th century. This is the new hall, built by the first Sir Michael de Fleming in the 16th century, enlarged in the 17th century, altered and refaced in the 18th century, with the main front based from the early 19th century. The old hall was closer to the present road, but was in ruins by the end of the 16th century. The village of Rydal was built on the old trade route between Ambleside and Keswick, originally a pack horse trail, but developed into a turnpike road in the 18th century. There was also a medieval deer park dating from the 13th century on the other side of the river, and this shaped development of the village as no building or settlement was permitted within the park. We would like to remind passengers upstairs to please remain seated and keep your arms inside the doors whilst the vehicle is moving. Thank you. Thank you. photographed building in the Lake District. Originally built in Manhattan, on the side of the residents, now part of the building in the area around the world. It was built on a stop deck in the state of Manhattan. It's believed that at one time, a tiny two-room building housed the family of six children. We are now travelling to Apple Side. There has been a settlement here for over 2,000 years dating back to the Romans at Hilada. After the Roman Empire declined, the area came under the control of Furness Abbey, near Barrow in Furness, which introduced small-scale managed industrialisation with farming and iron ore smelting. Over time, slate quarrying became a major export industry, whilst farming expanded, and the dissolution of the monasteries led to philanthropy divided up into numerous small holdings by 1550. The Industrial Revolution brought new technology to the area. The road system was transformed from muddy, rutted cart tracks to reliable roads, and water, bark, and bobbin mills were built alongside watercourses. Stockhill still had the remnants of waterwheel housings near its banks. By the late 19th century, the town had expanded as the tourist industry caught up and overtook the mills as a source of income. The transport connections had vastly improved with the arrival of the railway in Windermere, and big northern industrial towns lost their materials to the market.